Hi students, let us move on to the module 3, public key cryptography. Before going to public key cryptography, we can study what you mean by a private key cryptography. We had already discussed about the private key cryptography in first and second module. So the private key cryptography, it's a traditional way of cryptography, or it's a conventional encryption method. Encryption bar decryption method. It's otherwise known as private key cryptography or secret key cryptography or single cryptography. Also, it is otherwise known as symmetric key cryptography. Why it is known as symmetric key cryptography? Because both the sender and the receiver can use the same key. So only one key is used in the case of private key cryptography, and that should be shared by the parties. Here the sender and the receiver are equal, or the communicating parties are equal. Okay, so this is actually private key cryptography. But in the case of public key cryptography, it is asymmetric in nature. Why it is known as asymmetric? Because they use two separate keys. One is used for encryption and another is used for decryption. So a pair of keys are used. Okay, that is why they are known as asymmetric in nature. Some of the algorithms that are under the public key cryptography are RSA, Diffie-Hellman key exchange mechanism, DSS, elliptic curve cryptography. These are all the private key cryptographic algorithms. Okay, so comparison between the symmetric key and public key. Symmetric key is otherwise known as conventional encryption. Here the same algorithm with the same key is used for both the encryption and decryption, and the sender and receiver must share the same key, and this key should be kept secret, and it must be imposible or at least impractical to decipher a message if no other information is available. Here the knowledge of the algorithm plus the samples of ciphertext must be insufficient to determine the key. In the case of public key encryption, we had already said that it is asymmetric in nature because they use two separate keys or a pair of keys. Okay, and sender and the receiver must each have one of the matched pair keys. Okay, and one of the two keys should be kept secret. That means one should be private key and other should be public key. It must be impossible or at least impractical to decipher a message if no other information is available. Also, if we have a knowledge of algorithm and knowledge of keys, one of the keys and plus samples of ciphertext, it must be insufficient to determine the other key. So this is the comparison between the conventional encryption and public key encryption. Conventional encryption, it is otherwise known as a private key encryption or a symmetric encryption, and the public key encryption, which is otherwise known as asymmetric encryption. Okay. So what are the six ingredients of public key cryptography? We had already said that in private key, there should be five ingredients, right? One is plain text, cipher text, encryption algorithm, decryption algorithm, and a secret key. Here, six ingredients are there. Which are they? One is plain text, the original message that's sent by the sender, right? Encryption algorithm, the algorithm which is used for encrypting the plain text. Decryption algorithm, algorithm that is used for deciphering the cipher text. And what is cipher text? It is the output of encryption, or it's a scrambled message or transformed message. Right, along with these four ingredients, we have two keys, right? Two separate keys are there. One is kept secret, that is actually known as a private key, and the other is public, that is why they are known as public key. So a pair of keys are there. Which are they? Public key and private key. Private key is kept secret, public key is publicly available. So these are all the six ingredients of a public key cryptography. So this is the figure which shows the public key cryptography. We have a plain text, encryption algorithm, decryption algorithm, and cipher text. along with two keys are there. One is PUA and other one is PRA. What is PU? It's public key. What is PR? It's private key. A stands for the center A, right? Sorry, here receiver is the, that is Alice. Next, what are the applications of a public key? Mainly three applications are there. They are used for both encryption or decryption purpose, and it's also used for digital signature and also for key exchange mechanisms. Okay. What are the applications of public key cryptography? Main three applications are the, one is used for encryption or decryption process. Second one is digital signature, and the third one is key exchange mechanism. So we have a number of algorithms under public key cryptography. Examples, RSA, elliptic curve, Diffie-Hellman and DSS. And we have three applications. One is encryption or decryption process, digital signature and key exchange. Then RSA is responsible for all this application, or it is used for all these applications. Elliptic curve, again, it is used for all the three applications. But Diffie-Hellman DSS, which is only used for only, it's only used for one application. That is, Diffie-Hellman is used for key exchange and DSS is used for digital signature. Okay. Next, we have a public key crypto systems. We have a plain text sent by the source A. We have a destination B, or a pair of keys are the public key and private key. Public key of receiver and private key of receiver is the. So also this public key crypto system, which is used for providing authentication as well as confidentiality. If we are providing authentications, we are using the center's private and public key. If we are providing confidentiality, we are using receiver's public key and private key. You can see in this figure, that is y is equal to e of PRA comma x and x equal to d of PUA comma y. Here PRA is the center's private key and PUA is the center's public key. So for achieving authentications, we are using center's public key and private key. For achieving confidentiality, you can see, sorry, the public key and private key of the receiver. If you are providing both the authentication and confidentiality, you are using two pairs of key, the public key and private key of sender as well as the public key and private key of the receiver. Okay. So this is the figure which shows the authentication as well as confidentiality. Here, two pairs of keys are used, that is four keys are used, public and private keys of center A source and public and private key of center, I mean receiver B. Okay. And what are the public key requirements? It's computationally easy for a party B to generate a pair. Also, it's computationally easy for a sender knowing the public key and the message to be encrypted. Also, it's computationally easy for the receiver B to decrypt the resulting ciphertext along with the private key. Also, it's infeasible for an adversary knowing the public key to determine the private key. Also, it's computationally infeasible, that is knowing the public key and ciphertext to recover the original message. So here two keys are applied. One is public key and another one is private key. So these are all the requirements. And what are the security of a public key scheme? Here, like private key schemes, they are used for brute force exhaustive search attacks. Also, the keys are used too large. Also, it uses very large numbers for encryption, and they are slow compared to private key schemes. These are all the security measurements. So these are all about the introduction part of the public key cryptography.